Okay, Rikshokwa. Welcome, my relations. It's a very good day today for all those young warriors, I call them, that have achieved great challenges with great sacrifices. You have completed a part in your journey and all the things you will learn. You will now carry those out. I'm talking from the traditional territory of the Blackfoot Nation, under signed treaty 1877, and included Tsuut'ina and Stoney Nakoda. The original Blackfoot Confederacy consists of the Siksika, Kainai, Piikani, and the Southern Piikani in the United States. So, with from this territory, I welcome you. I continue to bless you with all the good things that you will help, and the learnings and the fruits of your learnings will help others. I greet you from the First Siksika First Nation. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Richard Sigurdsson. I'm Dean of the Faculty of Arts here at the University of Calgary. Welcome to Convocation, in this case, a virtual convocation. Convocation is always my favorite time of year at the university, when we see so many happy students cross the stage, supportive family members cheering from the stands, and we have faculty and staff that have come out to see our students that have earned one of their degrees. It's a great time. Unfortunately, we're going to do this virtually this year, but it's important nonetheless. Your achievement is, in fact, I think even greater given the challenges that you had to meet at the end of your academic career, getting through the pivot to online remote learning because of the COVID pandemic. Congratulations, great work. The Faculty of Arts is a large and diverse faculty, the largest in the university. We have everything from dance and music to psychology, economics, geography. But wherever you have taken your courses, we have tried hard to instill in you skills around critical thinking, creativity, resilience, understanding of equity and diversity. And we are confident that the skills and abilities that you've learned in the Faculty of Arts at the University of Calgary will set you up well for success in whatever career you follow, in your role as a citizen in society, and in your personal and active life as you go forward. We know that these are challenging times, and we know that this is a special kind of convocation for you. You won't be crossing the stage. You won't have family cheering for you in the stands, although I hope they will be able to join you virtually. We're still proud of the work that you've done. Your achievement is all the more special to have come through these difficult times. And what you've learned by having to do that will help set you up for success. I'd also like to thank your professors and instructors who over the years have worked hard to mentor you and to provide you with the skills and abilities that you need to move on. It's unfortunate they can't be here in their regalia. One of the nice things about convocation is that people dress up in their various gowns from various universities. So we're missing some of that color, but we're not missing the enthusiasm that our professors and instructors bring to seeing you achieve what you've achieved. We're very happy to see so many of you graduate. 1,100 graduates in undergraduate and graduate degrees in the Faculty of Arts this year alone. That's a very large number. The University of Calgary makes an impact in our communities. And we want to hear about what you do after you leave us. We hope that you will remain active as alumni of the University of Calgary and the University's Faculty of Arts. We know that there are many, many things that you can do to give back to the community, and we encourage you to do so. But for today, please enjoy it, enjoy your achievements, share with family and friends, and thank you very much for attending.
Hello, everyone. I want to take one more opportunity to congratulate all of you, because this is such a special milestone. You are part of a graduating class unlike any other, defined by both your resilience and your commitment to making the world a better place for everyone. You are the leaders and critical thinkers who will shape the future of our society. I want you to know how proud our university family is of all of you. And I want you to know how strongly we believe in your potential to make a positive impact. Graduates, congratulations.
First, and most important, congratulations on completing your degree. You are now graduates of the University of Calgary's Faculty of Arts, one of the extraordinary class of 2020. Your experience is different from that of every other year, and you will have tales to tell about this moment of time when the hiatus of a pandemic brought us all to a halt in an actual, if not virtual, sense. It's only too obvious to say that you are graduating in unusual conditions. When you began your program, you never imagined that you would be celebrating this way, that your cap would be sent through the mail and your gown would be imaginary. But that does not mean that your achievement is any the lesser. Your feeling of accomplishment should not be diminished because this is a virtual moment. I wish that I could see you now. One of the greatest pleasures of the academic year for your professors, your friends, and your family is convocation, watching you cross the platform, shining, most of you beaming, some of you close to tears, all of you filled with that ineffable sense of pride that a real accomplishment brings. You've worked hard, and the work that you have done is important. You've earned excellent degrees, and you can go forward with your future plans in full confidence that you have terrific preparation and training in your chosen area. Although, who can be prepared for what you are facing? You have completed your program at a time when there is a culture of conflict, disinformation, and COVID-19 fear. Lockdown stories, distancing stories, mask stories, sanitizer stories, sourdough stories, lineup stories, wash your hands stories, learning the ukulele, zooming around the world. It's a whole new language in a whole new territory. In this virtually flavored year, we're all focused on time and distance. How long will it be until we can return to doing what we want to do without hesitating, without thought? How far away from each other should we stand? When will we be able to spend time with friends, grab that coffee, and hug one another? So this is the year of questions, and many of them surround time and its indefinite, continuous progress, relentless, inescapable, and yet a dimension that you, more than any other generation, can affect. You will be the ones who change the limitations of time and space. You will be the ones who transcend the space hovering between us now. One of the best parts of being an art student is that you have opportunity to exercise choice. You get to choose your field of study, your courses, and yes, if you run into a professor that you'd sooner not listen to, you can change to a different class. By the way, I hope that you all completed your student ratings of instruction. That's the tool we use to improve our teaching performance. Most of all, the best aspect of university is that you have a chance to figure out what fires your passion and to shape that passion in order to take it with you out into the world. Your degree is in arts. A degree that means you are most likely to be asked, what are you going to do now? You chose arts because you are hungry to taste knowledge of different kinds, poetry and cartography, drama and people, history and politics, all the diverse knowledges that contribute to a person who really does know a measure of the many parameters of the world. Some people may not believe that your degree is practical or applicable, but you know it is pertinent in more ways than we can now imagine, and its applicability is subtler than what can be readily predicted. So much is needed beyond the technical, and you are the ones who have the training and the diverse background to undertake that. Whatever anyone tells you, you have opportunity. You have the skill of your discipline, you have the extensive background of your studies, and you have the capacity to be nimble and to ask the right questions. Arts and humanities, creativity and culture are words that are being tossed around with great abandon now. We've relied on culture to send us music and books and visual entertainment. We've relied on creativity to engage with open hours to contemplate humanity. These are not just buzzwords, but as important to life as fresh air. As graduates from this faculty, you know that the application of these subtler skills is much more than mere terminology, and that the skills you possess are much more abundant than an ability to communicate and an ability to discern nuance. You know how to enjoy solitude, how to read faces, how to determine what matters. You know the difference between strength and insight, the difference between a profession and a job, the difference between a promise and a lie. You know that ideas and concepts are not widgets or objects, but that they carry tangible weight. Memory and story are powerful tools in your path forward. And while you are rightly concerned about the direction of work and life in the coming years, you can set your own table. That may be a wobbly coffee table, a TV tray, a picnic table, or just a plank. But that is the greatest part of what you take away with your arts degree. You can set your own table. And what a rich and diverse table that is. You can lay out languages and economic strategies, the patterns of history and the consolations of literature, the nuances of psychology, and the features of geography. We all respect the STEM areas, and some of you will have double degrees, but you are the students with the communication skills, the translative skills, the analytical skills, the performative skills. You are the articulate, the ones who can speak to all the knotted and knotty issues in the world. You are our best hope. No one has had to tell you to be brave. And to be kind, you are that already. You have shown your investment in empathy through every generous act that you perform, individually and as a generation. Graduation is when people haul out old saws, cliches, advice, and opinions. People will tell you to believe in yourself, to get out there and solve all the problems waiting for you. You bear the weight of time's expectation. We expect you to fix the world that we older people have messed up. Find a vaccine, reshingle the roof, mend broken windows, pick up the garbage, reverse racism, and heal the rifts. I expect that you are sick of being told that you must fix the stumbling world. The burden of that responsibility might seem far too heavy in an era of job precarity, pandemic panic, and overall uncertainty. But you are aware of those humanistic challenges we face. You are the cohort who have identified the most urgent concerns of this spinning world: climate change, racism, ableism, sexism. You know when to turn the focused light of fury on what is happening. You know the effect of deployed algorithms. You recognize when false moral equivalences and outright lies are circulated. And you value shared reasoning, the bridging of differences, public institutions, cooperative interdependence. You are the model. You have the capacity to engage with exploratory professions, those that require strategy, smart thinking, effective messaging, and digital civility. You are the class of empathy, equality, and empiricism. You've embraced the unknowable, and you have the tools, inquiry, wonder, and deliberation to shove all of us into a world beyond our imaginings, a better world. So I urge you to have confidence in what you know, what you believe, and what you can do. My only advice is to give yourself one small task. Each and every day, record one joy and one worry, small or great, significant or not. Remember to read well. Reading makes you ideally equipped to interpret the meaning of situations. And be a lifelong learner. What do you carry along with your degree? Curiosity, openness, and ability to contemplate. The story of the future is yours to tell. Nobody can direct your narrative, but you can. Imagination is your realm. And even if Doc Brown from Back to the Future says, whatever you do, don't go to 2020 in the DeLorean time machine, you know that you can turn this rift in the space-time continuum around. And if the time is out of joint, and you wish you could return back to some other future, no matter where you land, and whatever state the DeLorean is in, you know how to make it fly. Perhaps the machines that we humans have made have carried us far away from sweeter values. But, and here is a word that arts graduates live with, you graduate with hope. I quote the poet Khalid Matawa, now that we have tasted hope, this hard-earned crust, we would sooner die than seek any other taste to life, any other way of being human. You are the best of human. Travel with hope.
Hi everyone, my name is Laura Hines. I'm an assistant professor of voice at the University of Calgary. And as a graduation gift today, I'd like to offer you a song. A song is important, I think, because it carries our words with such care. This song was originally penned in the 1920s and later became one of the anthems of the civil rights movement in the 60s. And you'll hear me sing this in duet with my voice teacher. Graduates, in whatever you do, bring your voice. Let it be one of the sparks that helps to change our world for the better. Congratulations, class of 2020.
This is a lie. This light of mine, I Thank you.